Hello kids, a very warm welcome to all of you on Basman Play School Kusum Bihar. So this will be a part 2 video of our EVS class. In this part, we will study about Unit 2 of Environmental Studies provided for Level 3 UKG. Unit 2nd name is My Surroundings. And what is the meaning of My Surroundings? So surrounding means those things which is nearby your house, which is nearby you, that means surrounding. So in this chapter, we will study about that we live in which type of environment, we live in which type of house, and we see which type of things around your house. So first, let's study about chapter 4 that will be consisting in unit 2, that is My Home. So in chapter 4, we will study about My Home. So first of all, we will know that what is My Home and which things we do in our house, which things we see in our home. We all live in a house, of course. You all live in a house. Our house is our home. Okay, so here that what is the difference between, so here our house is our home. Okay, so home, so here our house is our home, that a house called home. Our house protect us from heat, cold and rain. Yes, when we are in our house and if it is raining outside, then we will not be wet because we are in our house. If we'll go outside, that time we can be wet. So it means that our house is protecting us from the rain. Again, in the sunlight, if we are going outside, then we will feel so much hot. But if we'll come inside our house, that time we will feel good. It means that the house is also protecting us from the heat. And in the winter season, if we are going outside, then we will feel so much cold. But if we will come inside our house, that time we will feel a little bit good. Why? Because our house is protecting us. Okay, it protects us from animals and thieves. Yes. Okay, so in the night, yeah, maybe in the day, nobody can enter in our house without our permission, like animals, like thieves, right? Because our house protect us from animals and thieves. In night or in the anytime, we put some lock on our gate, and from that nobody can enter in our houses. We feel happy and safe in our house. When we are in our house, we feel so much good, we feel so happy, and we feel safe. You just feel that when you come from your school, in your house, you feel so good. You just put off your uniform, you just put off your bag, so, and you feel so much relaxed. Why? Because a house is giving you so much happiness and safety. That's why you are feeling happy and safe in your house. We take rest and sleep here. Yeah, we also take rest and sleep in our house. Like in the night, we sleep. When we are so much exhausted, that time we take rest. It means that in our house we can take rest and we can sleep also. Okay, we cook and eat food here. In our house, there is one room, that's name is kitchen, and in that kitchen we can cook food. We can also help to our mother, and we can eat food in our house. We store our things in our house. All the things which are belonging to us, we put all the things in our cupboard, that is inside our house. We cannot throw, we cannot put all the things outside of our house because it is not safe. That's why we will put all the things which are related to us, like books, like dresses, like shoe, and like many other things. We keep that in our houses. Okay, we play and have fun in our house. Sometime if we are not going outside, then that time we can play some indoor games, some board games like carom, like chess. We can also read some story books. It can feel so much good. So we can also play in our houses. We can play some indoor games and we can have a lot of fun in our houses. We study and walk here. In our house, we do a lot of things, like we also study, we work. So let's move to the exercise. This was a chapter that's name was My Home. We just studied about My Home, that which things we do in our home and what is home. Also, a home protect us from which things, what we can do in our houses, and many more. So let's see what are exercises. So first, take on the right statements. Like what is right statement, you have to take that, and what is wrong, you have to cross that. First statement is, we sleep in our house. Yes, we have studied just now that we sleep in our house, so it can be tick, like it is right. We cook and eat our food in the park. No, it is wrong, because in the park we should not cook and we should not eat anything. Okay, so we can cross it. Next question is that we should keep our house clean. Of course, you all kids should try to keep clean your houses, because it is very much important. When you are coming from school, you should arrange your all the things like bags, so and books in a proper manner, and you have to put your lunch box in the sink of kitchen. So by these ways you can clean keep clean your house, so it can be right tick. We feel safe in our house. Yes, tick. Our house protect us from heat and rain. Yes, this is also true. As we just studied about that, we can feel safe from heat and rain when we are in our house. So now let's talk about question number 2. This is, color the things which are used to build a house. In this question, we have to color all the things which we use to build a house. Normally, this is telephone. We don't use that. Okay. This is the instrument which we use when we make our houses. So we can color this one. Also, we can color this brick, because with this because we use this brick to make our wall to our house. And this is Tata cement. Yes, you have to color this also, because without cement we cannot imagine to make our houses. This is iron, which we do not use to make our houses, so you will not color this. This is drum. This will also not used when we make our houses, so it will not be colored. This is truck. Yeah, it is used for like what you call carrying many like goods, like bricks, like cements, like sand. So we can color this one. This is also an instrument which we use while we make our houses, so you have to color this one also. After my home, in chapter 5, we will study about my school. In this chapter, we will know about what is school and why we should go to school. This is my school. Okay, this is the building of school, and kids are also going inside the school. A school is a place where we go to learn many things. Okay, so a school is that place where we go for learn lot of things, like reading, like writing, like art, like doing art and craft, and like many other activities we learn in school. That's why we go to school, for learn many things. In a school, we learn to read and write. Yes, in a school, we learn how to read and how to write anything. We learn to play games. Yes, because in a school, we play a lot of games. That's why we know how to play different type of games. We learn to share our things to our friends, like your pencil, your sharpener, your eraser, like your food. This is really very good manners, which we learn from the school. The teacher teach us all these activities in the school. So who make us learn all the activities in the school? That is our teachers who make us learn to all the activities. There are many rooms and a playground in my school. Okay, there are many rooms, like some computer room, some art and craft room, some activity area. There are many rooms, and also there is one playground in my school. Kids, we should go to school regularly, because many kids don't want to go to school regularly. So if you're not going to school regularly, then you can miss lot of things, like how to play any particular game, how to do some kind of activities. That's why you all should go to school regularly. So let's see first question, that is, answer the following question, oral practice. Okay, this is for only oral. What is the name of your teacher? You have to say your teacher name, like your class teacher name. Next question is that, who is the principal of your school? So you have to also say your principal name. You have to learn that, your teacher name and your principal name. That is very much important. Name your best friend in school. Okay, so who is your best friend in the school, in your classroom? You have to tell the name of your best friend. Okay, not for house. You have to say your school's best friend, right? What do you like the most in your school? Okay, so which things you like to do most in your school, like reading, writing, playing, doing some activities? That's you have to mention here, that which things you like the most in your school. tick on the activities you do in the school. You have to tick all the things which you do in the school. So first, wash clothes. You wash clothes in the school? No. So you have to cross it. Make friends? Yes. We make lot of friends in our school. So you have to tick it. Learn? Yes. We learn in the school. We will tick it. Sleep? No. We should not sleep in the school because it is really bad manner and we don't sleep in the school. So this can be cross. Next, play. Of course, we play different type of games in the school. So you have to tick it. Break things? No. We should not break anything in the school, not even in house. So you have to cross it. Draw? Yes. We learn how to drawing. And cook food? No. We don't cook food in the school. Have fun? Yes, of course. We have lot of fun with our friends in a school. So you have to tick it. Exercise? Yes. In our assembly time, that time we do exercise after prayer. So you have to tick it also. So which things you do in a school? Make friends, learn, play, draw, have fun and exercises. These all are the activities which you do in your school. So children, let's see question number 3. This is circle the things you find in your school, like which things you find in your school, you have to circle that. So this is a swing. If you find swing in your school, then you have to circle it. This is the blackboard. Yeah, definitely you have seen this in your classroom. So you have to circle it. This flower vase, if you have seen this in your class, in your school, then you have to take circle it. Otherwise, you can leave it. And this is the horse toy. You can also leave it because this we cannot find in your school. Litter box, we cannot find in our school. Umbrella, we cannot find in our school. And desk, of course, we can find in our school. So you have to circle this bench. This blackboard and this swing. Okay, so these all are the things which we can find in our school. So children, let's study about chapter 6. This chapter name is Our Neighborhood. And in this chapter, we will study about all the place which we can find nearby our house. That's called our neighborhood. Okay, so what is neighborhood? Neighborhood. So what is neighborhood? Neighborhood is that place which we can find nearby our house. So let's study about that. The places near our house from our neighborhood. Okay, it means that as I told you that which places we can see nearby our house, that is our neighborhood. Right? Again, which places we can see, we can find nearby our house, that is our neighborhood. There are many other places near our houses. Okay, right? There are so many places. You have seen many places like some market, some school, some hospital and many more. Some of them are park, right? You have also seen some park nearby your house, school, post office, market, police station, fire station, hospital, temple, etc. These are all the things which we can mostly find nearby our houses, and these all places will be called our neighborhood. Let's do study about all the things one by one. You can see some picture. Can you tell me this is a picture of which place? This is the market, and it is also include, and it will also include in our neighborhood. We use market for purchasing many things like some grains, some fruits, some toys, some dresses, some vegetables and many more. When we have to purchase anything, then immediately we go to the market. Okay, so market is also very important for us, because if market will not be there, we cannot purchase anything which is required for us. So next picture you can see, can you tell me what is this? This is a picture of hospital. That's why you can find some hospital nearby your houses. When anybody becomes sick, that time they immediately go to the hospital, and it is really important that when we are finding some house for us for living, that time we must find some hospital nearby our house. So children, can you tell me what is the next picture? This is a picture of post office. You know why we use post office and why do we go through the post office? Post office is used for sending and receiving letters and sending and receiving any couriers. So that's why if we have to send any letters to our relative, to our friends and to anybody, that time we go to the post office. Children, can you see what is the picture? This is a picture of fire station. When there is some fire wedding, that time we call immediately to fire station and some firemen come to our house and anybody's house and they blew out all the fire. So it is very important that some fire station should be nearby our house. So it will be also called our neighborhood. Tell me the picture of this. This is a picture of park, and we use for enjoying, for playing some game in the evening when we come to the school, and in the evening we become so tired. Usually go to the park, we feel so refreshed and relaxed because there are so many trees, so many plants, so many flowers, and by seeing all the greeneries, all the green plants, green trees, green flowers, we become so happy and our mood become so refreshed. So children, next neighborhood place is, that name is police station. This is very much important, like when something wrong happened to our house, like when some thief came and they stole something from our house, that time we immediately called to the police station for catching the thief. So children, next neighborhood place name is temple. We go to the temple for worship to God, and on the day of our birthday and on any auspicious occasion, we go to the temple to worship the God. Next neighborhood place name is school. It is very much important because you all go to the school, and school is our second house. So children, these all are the places which we can find in our neighborhood. These all places will be also called our neighborhood. Now let's do some exercises about this chapter. Let's see question number 1. Answer the following question. This will be for oral practice. First question is that, name 3 places in your neighborhood. You have to tell the name of 3 places which you find in your neighborhood. That can be school, hospital and park. Okay. So next question is that, question number B, from where do we buy medicines? We can buy medicines from hospital and from medical shops which is in our market. So we can purchase or buy medicines from both the places, from market and from hospital. Next question is, from where do we buy things of our need? Like if we need anything, like if we want some fruits, some vegetables and anything, then where we go to the purchase? We go to the market to buy all the things. From where do we get stamps, postcards and envelopes? So from which place we can purchase all the things, like stamps, like postcards, like envelopes? So we can purchase all these things from post office. Okay, we can purchase this thing, these things from post office also, and we can also send and receive letters from the post office, right? What does a policeman do? Policeman catch the thieves. Okay, they catch the thieves. So kids, next question is that, match the following. So you have to match all these words with suitable words. So first word is that park. So in parks we can see swings, so you have to mark swings. Dairy, in dairy shop we can find some milk and milk products, so find out where's the milk. Money, medicine, buses, swings and milk. Here's the milk, so we will match this dairy with milk. Next word is post office. So from post office we can purchase stamps, so you have to match the post office with the stamps. Next to that person who sell the medicines in a medical shop or in a hospital. So from the chemist we can purchase medicines. Next one is bank. In bank we can deposit or withdraw the money. Bus stop, which we can see on bus stop, we can see buses. Okay children, next question is that, tick on the place you see in your neighborhood. You say temple, yes. You say food seller, you have to tick it. If there's some college, you can tick it, otherwise you can cross it. Bakery, then you can tick it. Chemist, tick. School, yes, you have to tick. Bank, you can also tick it. If there's some bank nearby your house, then you can tick it. Next one is hospital, tick. Market, tick. Petrol pump, no, it is on the side of road, like on highways, so we cannot tick the petrol pump, we can cross it. Post office, tick. Cinema hall, no. Railway station, no. If you not find any railway station nearby your house, we can find railway station like a little bit far from our house. And park, you have to tick also. Okay, So kids, let's see question number 4. That is, match the following things with the places from where we buy them. Okay, like first picture is, can you tell me what is this? This is envelope. You can purchase envelope from post office. Okay. Next one is that toothpaste, shampoo, brush, that you can we can purchase from general store. That is in last. Okay. So you have to match this with this general store. Book we can purchase from stationery shop. Okay, so you have to match book with stationery. Next one is that this is a syrup, like it is the type of medicine. So we can match this syrup with chemist, right? You can also match these things too. Like first is medicine, so you can match medicines with chemist. Soap with general store. Pen with stationery and envelope with that post office. Okay. So children, next and our last question is that see the following pictures and discuss in the class where these people are going. You can see there are so many person. They are going to somewhere. Can you tell me this is the name of which person? This is postman. He is going to deliver the letters. And she is vegetable seller. She is going to sell vegetables. And he is a doctor. So children, these are all about the my surrounding unit 2. In that unit, we covered today 3 chapters. Chapter 4, my home. Chapter 5, my school. And chapter 6, our neighborhood. There are 2 chapters more. First one is a park. That will be chapter 7. And then there will be in the market. This chapter we will cover in next video. So children, that's all for today's class. You got all the things about my surroundings. So see you next video. Till then, bye bye all of you. Take care.